Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, That Model Railway Guy, for a more relaxed video today. A while back, I took a trip to the North Yorkshire Moors Railway, and I finally gotten round to editing together some of the footage from that trip, so that's what today's video is all about. While the NYMR is predominantly a steam railway, the first train I saw out of Grosmont was actually hauled by a Class 31 headed for Whitby. At the other end of the line, the 4MT 80116 was just arriving into Pickering. Locos generally take on water at Pickering before the long climb back over the Yorkshire Moors for the return journey. And with that, it was time for the train to depart. Thank you. Meanwhile, the Class 31 had arrived into Whitby and was now ready to run round its train. We jump now to Levisham, where the 4MT was arriving into the station. This is often where trains pass each other, and so this was a fantastic opportunity to see resident Black 5 Eric Tracy coming in the opposite direction. Even between trains, Grosmont is a hive of activity, especially around the MPD. Today, the 9F was going through a steam test under the coal tower, which provided an opportunity to get some nice shots of it. Unfortunately, a minor issue was discovered with the 9F, causing it to fail its steam test. As a result, the diesel shunter was called upon to push it back towards the shed. Back at Pickering, the Black 5 had arrived and was ready to run round its train. Meanwhile, up at Grosmont, the 4MT had arrived. As this loco isn't mainline certified, it's not allowed to run on the section between Grosmont and Whitby. This means it had to be swapped out for another loco. There's never a dull moment at Grosmont though, as around the same time the J27 was required to retrieve some empty coaches from the sidings. This cleared the line, allowing the 4MT to head back to the shed. And shortly afterwards, school's class Repton was able to shunt onto the train. The J27 was then able to haul the empty coaching stock into the opposite platform, ready for its own departure. And with everyone on board, the train was ready to start its journey to Pickering. As we leave the station, here you can see the signal box just before the level crossing. There's also some nice viewing points just beside the line here, which is great for photographers and filmmakers. If you do ever visit the NYMR, there's actually enough going on at Grosmont that you could spend an entire day there just watching all the engine movements. Picking back up with the Black 5 again, this had made its way to Gothland and was now ready to depart. In the opposite platform, a dining train was also in use, which was also ready for its own departure. Further up the line, on the way into Whitby, you pass under this stunning viaduct just before arriving into the station. With Repton having successfully run round its train, it was once again time to depart Whitby. In addition to passing back under the viaduct, there's also another station on this section, although NYMR trains don't stop here, passing straight through. Later in the day, the 4MT was returning with the dining train, although what had originally been planned as a nice shot to get the train passing by didn't go quite as expected. The train was brought to a stand just outside Grosmont with the signal set against it. After a little bit of a wait, it turned out that the signal had failed and the train was given permission to pass the signal at danger. Having safely arrived back into Grosmont, it then met up with the school's class, which was also returning from Whitby. Anyway, that's it for today's video, everyone. I do hope you've enjoyed looking at some real trains today instead of the model ones. This is a tiny fraction of the footage I shot during my visit to the NYMR, and I'll actually be posting some additional videos for channel members later this month. So, if you'd like to see more from this trip, do consider becoming a member, and of course, you do get early access to all my other videos as well. Like I said though, that's it for today. If you haven't already, please do subscribe, it really does help out, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching, everyone. Bye.